When your MRI says disc extrusion, it means the soft center of your spinal disc is actually broken through the outer wall. And when that happens, it can press directly on a nerve root, causing sharp back pain, burning leg pain, even numbness and tingling that just won't go away. Most people are told the only option is surgery, but that's not the whole story. There are advanced non-surgical methods that can reduce pain, release muscle tension, promote true healing, and even help pull the extrusion back in. This can take pressure off the nerves, so mobility improves, back pain decreases, and leg pain can actually disappear. In this video, you'll discover exactly how a disc extrusion causes pain, why it's different from a bulge or protrusion, and the revolutionary treatment that is changing how we actually help patients recover without surgery. Hi, I'm Dr. John Zielonka. I'm a neurofunctional chiropractor in Ottawa, Ontario, Canada, with 35 years of clinical experience. My YouTube channel focuses on helping those who've been suffering from debilitating chronic back and neck pain. Before I dive into today's video, I need you to smash the subscribe button if you want to learn more tips and strategies on how to treat and relieve debilitating back and neck pain without drugs, without surgery. I upload a new video every week. To understand what disc extrusion really means, let's compare the two other common terms you might see, disc bulge and disc protrusion. A disc bulge is when the outer wall of the disc actually pushes it outward evenly. It's almost like air pressing against the side of a balloon. The wall is stretched, but it hasn't broken. A disc protrusion is more focal, so the disc material pushes out in one spot, but the base is still wider than the tip. The outer wall is weakened, maybe even partially torn, but it's still holding together. A disc extrusion, on the other hand, is when the inner gel or of the disc actually breaks through the outer wall. So sort of think of toothpaste squeezing out of a tube. Now the material can extend beyond the disc and even irritate or compress the nearby spinal nerves. That's why an extrusion is more likely to cause problems than a bulge or a protrusion. It isn't always about size. It's about the fact that a disc's contents are exposed and the nerves don't like that. The result? You're going to get sharp, burning pain down the leg, numbness, tingling, even weakness. This is what many people know as sciatica. Now, here's the important part. Knowing the anatomy of a disc extrusion isn't just academic. It's the key to choosing the right treatment. When the disc material is broken through, in other words, the disc extrusion, you can't treat it with the usual approaches, that hot pack, cold pack, electrical stimulation, injections, or some general back stretches. They might give short-term relief, but they do nothing to solve the underlying problem. An extrusion needs a more advanced solution, one that takes pressure off the nerve, reduces inflammation on the root, and creates the conditions for the disc to retract and heal. The treatment must do three things. Number one, it's got to relieve pressure on the nerve. Number two, it's got to reduce that surrounding inflammation. And number three, it's got to give the body a chance to retract or heal the extrusion itself. This is why so many people are worried about surgery. They've heard stories of long recovery times, which are very true. Recurring disc problems, scar tissue, complications that leave them worse off. Surgery can help in certain cases, but with significant risks, and most patients want to avoid that if there's a safer, less invasive way to get results. The good news, there are advanced non-surgical treatments that do exactly that. They reduce pain, ease muscle tension, promote healing, and even create the negative pressure needed to help pull an extrusion back inward. When that happens, the nerve root gets relief, mobility improves, back pain eases, and the leg pain can disappear altogether. In a moment, I'll reveal a new and revolutionary way of treating those disc extrusions that only relieves pain, but also restores mobility and reduces nerve irritation, and it's been shown to have over a 90% success rate. Now, this method is powerful on its own, but here's the key. True disc healing doesn't just come from one treatment. The real transformation happens when we combine this approach with six other critical steps that make up what we call our neurospinal restoration program. Those steps include neuromuscular reeducation, disc replenishment in the healing protocols, neurofunctional spinal correction, muscle tissue restoration, lifestyle factors, all as an individualized treatment program tailored to each patient. Now, when you put all those together, the healing effect compounds. Every step works in synergy, addressing the disc, the nerves, the muscles, and the underlying spinal function. So what is revolutionary step number seven? The one that makes the difference for patients with disc herniations and extrusions, it's called non-surgical robotic laser spinal decompression. This advanced technology gently creates negative pressure inside the disc. It reduces nerve compression, it promotes rehydration, and even helps draw the extruded material back towards its normal position. Combined with the other six steps, it's a game changer for patients who want lasting relief without surgery. So what exactly is a neurospinal restoration program? Well, when that disc is damaged and extruded, it sets off more than just mechanical compression on the nerve. It triggers a whole cascade of inflammatory reactions. The disc material that leaks out is rich in chemical mediators. These are substances that irritate the surrounding tissue and the nerve root itself. The irritation leads to swelling, muscle guarding, and an amplified pain response. That's right, it's going to make you feel that you're even in more pain. It's why patients often feel not only sharp back pain, but burning, shooting pain down the leg that can become unbearable. This is where non-surgical robotic laser spinal decompression is so revolutionary. Unlike basic traction tables or temporary therapies, the technology does three critical things for an extrusion. Number one, it reduces the mechanical compression. So that's just how much force is actually on that disc by creating negative pressure inside the disc. You've heard me say that over and over, you've got to create the negative pressure. This gentle vacuum effect helps pull nutrients and fluids back in. And in some cases, it can even assist in retracting the extruded material away from the nerve root as well. Number two, it calms that inflammatory response. So the integrated laser component promotes cellular healing. It reduces swelling. It helps quiet the chemical mediators that are driving pain. This means less irritation around the nerve and less muscle spasm protecting the injured area. Number three, it promotes disc healing and rehydration. By restoring fluid exchange in the disc, the tissue gets the nutrition it needs to recover, something a damaged extrusion desperately requires. Now, when you combine those effects, patients often notice not only relief of back pain, but a dramatic reduction or elimination of leg pain as the nerve root pressure and the inflammatory response actually resolves. And when this treatment is integrated into a larger neurospinal restoration program, it doesn't just mask symptoms, it addresses the root causes and gives the disc its best chance to heal. So just how successful is this treatment? The results with non-surgical robotic laser spinal decompression have been remarkable. Patient outcomes in our clinic show over a 90% success rate in patients with disc herniations and disc extrusions. Success doesn't just mean less pain for a few days, it means patients who were told surgery was their only option now have a path to recovery without the significant risks, downtime, or uncertainty of an operation. It means people who couldn't sit, couldn't stand, couldn't walk without sharp pain shooting down the leg are now moving freely again. We've seen patients regain mobility, get rid of constant back pain, and experience complete elimination of leg pain and sciatica symptoms. Many go from barely making it through the day to getting back to work, back to exercise, and back to living the life they thought was lost. Most importantly, these are patients who avoided the knife. They avoided surgical risks, avoided long recovery periods, and avoided the possibility of failed back surgery. Instead, they found a treatment that not only relieved their pain, but helped their disc heal, protected their spine for the future, and gave them their quality of life back. And when you combine this advanced decompression technology with the other six steps of our neurospinal restoration program, that's when the real transformation happens. Pain relief, restored function, and long-term stability, all without surgery. If you're struggling with a disc extrusion, I want you to know this. Don't lose hope. Even if you've already tried other treatments that haven't worked, you are not doomed. In so many cases, surgery can still be avoided. I've seen it time and time again. The key is finding the right kind of care. Look for a chiropractor who's trained in spinal decompression. Why a chiropractor? Because the best ones are the experts in spinal decompression. And if you can find one who offers non-surgical robotic laser spinal decompression, even better. There are only 12 of these systems in the world. If you happen to be in the Ottawa, Ontario area, come check us out. We'd love to meet you and see if this treatment is the right solution for you. If you found value in this video and learned something new, please leave a like and a share so more people with back and leg pain can get help. Drop a comment below if you have any questions about non-surgical robotic laser spinal decompression, and I'll do my best to answer them. And remember to subscribe if you want more tips and strategies on how to relieve back and neck pain without drugs and without surgery. The next video you should watch is this one right here, 5 of the best exercises for an L5-S1 disc bulge and leg pain relief. Please go watch this one next.